Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome at the press briefing of the Minister of National Defense, Antoni Macierewicz, and the Secretary General, Jens Stoltenberg. Mr. Minister, the floor is yours.
Bardzo dziękuję za to zaproszenie do tego, bym pierwszy zabrał głos, ale dzisiaj przeżywamy tak nieprawdopodobnie historyczny moment, tak wielką chwilę, a na którą Polska czekała dziesiątki lat. Po raz pierwszy sekretarz generalny NATO jest w Polsce.
Thank you very much for the possibility that I can speak as the first person, but let me say that today is a very historical day, a very special and unique day for which Poland has been waiting for dozens of years, because this is the first time that the Secretary General visits the eastern flank, visits the soldiers of the battalion battle group, which are here to defend us and to deter any aggression. So allow me to ask the Secretary General to take the floor as the first one, because it's a great day for NATO and it's a great day for Jens Stoltenberg.
Thank you so much, Minister Macierewicz. It is a great honor to be here today and to meet with you and to meet the soldiers of the NATO battle group here in Poland. As you said, it is historic because this is the first time NATO deploys a multinational battalion battle group of combat-ready forces to this part of our alliance. And the battle group here in Poland is part of a broader adaptation and response of NATO to a more demanding and challenging security environment. We are now having battle groups in Estonia, in Latvia, in Lithuania, and in Poland. And that's a direct result of the decisions we made at a very successful NATO summit in Warsaw last year in July. And a year after, we are able to deliver on the most important decision, the readiness, the deployment of our battle groups to the three Baltic countries and Poland. The battle groups are very important because they show NATO's resolve, NATO's unity, and they also send a very strong message of multinational unity of NATO, a strong message of deterrence. Because by being multinational, by having forces from many different NATO allies stationed here, we send a clear signal that an attack on one ally will be regarded as an attack on the whole alliance. And that is the core of NATO. That is what NATO is all about. That is our Article 5, collective defense, one for all and all for one. And it's very reassuring to see that in praxis with the multinational battle group deployed here in Poland. Then I would also like to say that we all know that our freedom doesn't come for free. And Poland know that very well, because you have such a troubled history. And therefore, you know that we have to invest in our defense, in our security, to make sure that we continue to be free. Therefore, I welcome what you do in so many different ways, supporting, contributing to NATO, to our collective defense. You are investing in new capabilities, which are important for Poland, but also for the whole alliance. And you are contributing to many different NATO missions and operations in Afghanistan, in Kosovo, in Iraq. And you are investing now 2% of GDP in defense. That is of great importance. And you are hosting a NATO command, so you are also hosting different NATO capabilities and capacities. We are now developing a ballistic missile defense site in Poland, and we are now also looking into what more we can do in Poland in the future. So once again, it is a great pleasure and honor to meet you. I would like to thank you, but not least, I would like to thank the soldiers who are serving here. Thank them for their commitment, for their service, and for what they do every day, making sure that we can live in peace, and making sure that NATO every day deliver credible deterrence. So it has been a great honor to be here and meet the soldiers and meet all of you today. Thank you.
Thank you. Ja dziękuję i przyłączam się do podziękowań, które pan sekretarz generalny NATO skierował, zwłaszcza wobec żołnierzy tutaj w Orzeszu, w Bemowie Piskim. Stacjonują poza żołnierzami Stanów Zjednoczonych, także żołnierze Rumunii, Wielkiej Brytanii. No i oczywiście wspierają ich żołnierze polscy.
Thank you very much, and I also would like to join your words of gratitude directed towards the soldiers serving in Orzesz and Bemowo Piski. We also have here soldiers from Romania, Great Britain, and they are also supported by Polish soldiers. So once again, thank you very much, but I also like to thank the Chief of Defense, General Surawski. I'd like to thank General Motacki and General Sokołowski and all the other officers and soldiers who have prepared this.
Excuse me, General Mika, once more, please. Excuse General.
I również chciałbym podziękować generałowi Mice and all the other soldiers that have prepared this area and have made it possible for this project to be successful, and all the soldiers that serve here for us to be free and so that we have the security that no adversary will ever attack our fatherland. This is especially important in times of the Zapad 17 exercises on Belarus that have a very unclear structure and a very unclear perspective. In addition to that, we see the war that is ongoing on Ukraine, and the NATO presence in this region in Poland is a result of the determination of the here present Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg, and it is a guarantee at the same time that peace will come back to Europe. So once again, Jens, thank you very much.
Thank you once more.